episode 1575, When Concerns Are Raised.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people happy, happy day. I hope your weekend is off to a beautiful start. Today is Relationship Builders Day, and you know what? When concerns are raised, what do you do? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, talking can be the most challenging in marriage. We can fumble over our words. We think we have the perfect thing, just the right way to say, and when it comes out, bleh, it's a mess. What to say when, how to say it when concerns are raised, how do you express yourself? Concerns can come from a variety of circumstances, voicing your opinion on a situation or sharing your side of the story, all of which you should be very comfortable with in a marriage. You should have a trusting relationship where if you don't like something, you can say it. But that's not the case in many marriages, let alone relationships. We are quick to jump down our partner's throat if what we say or think doesn't match with their opinion. Because they can express something, we're like, wow, and it's just like this lion and tiger and bear, oh my, that comes out of ourself, and we just like engulf them, words out of hate, words out of distrust. We can sit there and formulate thoughts that we hadn't even really put action to, but it comes out as if we've been thinking about it for years. And what does that do to a relationship? It kills it. And once you begin to go down the I'm right lane, disagreements and arguments are in your future. Guarantee. There aren't very many guarantees in life, but this is one of them. You go and tell somebody, you don't know what you're doing, and they believe wholeheartedly that they do know what they're doing, a fight is about to occur. Communication is a tough weed. We either do a great job or we stink at it. Regardless, it's the sting in a relationship that holds back intimacy. And that intimacy is the growth that keeps a marriage fresh and strong. I'm sure you've said a few things you wish you could have rephrased after you vomited it out of your mouth. You're like, oh man, I really didn't mean it that way and it came out really bad. But even if you apologize immediately, the hurt is already out there, right? Words have power. As for your partner, you can name many times where something has been said and is usually taken from a perspective of what? Negativity. We just kind of sit in it. And we probably actually can make a full list. And it wouldn't take long, right? You could write down and go, yep, he said this. Oh, I remember when he did this. And then he said that. When we were working on this project, you would not believe what came out of his mouth. And what do we find ourselves doing? We're complaining to our girlfriends. Sometimes the guys, yes, you guys, you'll go and talk to your guy friends. But most of the time, this is an issue for females because we replay the situation over and over and over again, usually making it what? Work in our favor. At least the story that we tell is working in our favor. Not necessarily the disagreement or the argument we might be in, the frustration that's building up, the anger within the relationship, no. But we feel better because, I'm going down the I'm right lane and I got it all together. So what can you do when concerns are raised, but you want to be heard too? Well, you got to speak out of love. That is your KISS the Keep It Simple strategy. Speak out of love. It's not a matter of being right or wrong. Yet, unfortunately, as human beings, we're all about the right part. And that's where most of us fail. We want to be right. We have this deep desire that, hey, I got this, and you so don't. It's not about pointing fingers. Keeping score is only going to get you into further trouble and deeper discussion that usually leads to what? An argument. That means you got a battle on your hands. And who wants a beautiful weekend to end up in a fight? Not me. Nobody wants that. The kids don't want that. You don't want that. The dog definitely doesn't want that. And the cats are sitting there. If they could, they had really big paws, they'd be putting it over their ears and their eyes going, would you just stop already? So speak out of love. What does that look like? What does it sound like? Well, number one, words should not cut someone into pieces. And we're great at doing that. Think about the last conversation you had regarding a project. I'm going to rewind to how my last day has gone. We're in the middle of a few projects here around the house. Believe it or not, I spoke about this, I don't know how many months ago, but we have two bathrooms, our master bath specifically and our guest bath. And the previous owners put up this beautiful, high quality wallpaper way back when they built the house. In my opinion, wallpaper should not exist. Now, if you're a wallpaper lover, I'm so sorry. I probably just hurt your feelings, but I'm going to speak out of love. In my bathroom, this design, I mean, it was a high quality paper. I'm not complaining about that. But the design that they picked and what they put up, I'm just like scratching my head. I mean, it was kind of like a weird kind of orangey maroon color that was kind of like a, I don't know, a geometric weird circle into like square rectangles. Anyway, it was crazy. Guess what? It all came down. Yes, the walls are now barren. Well, in our guest bathroom, it actually looked like we had spider webs on there, and they were decorative spider webs. It kind of was like a weird pineapple that had like a spider dropping down from it. It really wasn't a spider. I think it was some flowers, but from afar, yeah, it did not settle with me at all. High quality paper, might have been good when they built the house, but not in my taste. And wallpaper for me, I just don't like it. It's a pain. Guess what? It's out now. So my husband comes home. He's getting ready for the weekend, and we're kind of planning out what we want to go do as a family. My mom's still here from Hawaii, and we're like, okay, what do we have for the plans? What's on the calendar? And I could tell he wanted to ask me something, and he would just calmly, as he stood at the sink washing his hands, he said, you know, he goes, not that I'm pressuring you or anything, and I thought, okay, here it comes. Okay, you know how those statements come out, right? You're like, he's about to lay something on me. And you're like, come on, bring it on. Because what? You're starting to put up your fist already. Yeah. You don't want to get into a battle, so relax. So I was very calm and I was listening to every single word speak out of love, every single word that was coming out of his mouth. And he said, I don't want to put pressure on you, but I was just wondering, when do you think, and I knew exactly what he was going to say. And you know what? I did the worst thing. I jumped in before he even spoke. Finished his sentence. And I said, when am I going to start painting? And he goes, yeah. And I said, that's a good question. I said, today, maybe tomorrow or the next day. He goes, oh, okay. And that was it. Now for him, he really just wanted to know that we're not going to be living like this and seeing kind of just barren walls for the next like 2, 3, 4 weeks. He wanted to know that I had a plan. Now, if I would have totally gone back in time, 10, 15 years into our marriage, and he started out with the same comment, not to pressure you or anything, but I was wondering, I probably would have immediately gone down the I'm right and shot him up with words of frustration that, boy, he just doesn't have it all together. Why can't he just give me a break? I've been working hard. And all he really wanted to know is that I had a plan to get this accomplished where we would not be living in an undone master bath. He really wanted it and wants it finished. You got to speak out of love. Words should not cut someone into pieces. Words should lift up. All he was asking for was that, I just want to know, hun, that you got a plan. If you got a plan, I'm great with it. That's all I cared about. And guess what? He said everything right. I just kind of jumped in a little bit. Now, I wasn't mean either. I spoke out of love and he spoke out of love. And guess what? We ended with a smile and a great hug. It was fabulous. And guess what? Hopefully, in the next couple episodes, I'll have a good report saying that the master bath and the guest bath have now been painted. But that's for another episode. Number two, words should not declare the score of who's right or wrong. Words are true with a semblance of what? Compassion. You are considering the other person's perspective, not just your own. You don't need to consider just what you want or what you need. it's not all about you, right? The WIIFM, you got to be careful not to speak from that particular center, that station. Don't dial it up every single time you begin to start a conversation. It gets you into trouble. Speak out of love. And number three, words should not focus on the results desired as much as the growth of the relationship. Where do you want to go? Words speak love. It's the intimacy that says, I put you first above other outcome. I put you first above any other outcome. Yeah, he did. He just wanted to know I had a plan for the master bath. I had a plan for the guest bath. He didn't want to be living, coming home forever and ever and ever with unfinished business. He wanted to know that, by golly, I got this on the schedule somewhere. I juggle a lot, and he understands that. And he actually just wants to help facilitate whatever my plan is. Sometimes that means what? He's cooking. And you know how he cooks? He's going to pick up something. It's fast something or other. Somebody else is doing the cooking, not mama. And guess what? That's awesome. And that's how he can help facilitate the plan. But if we are not on the same page, if we are not understanding each other, if we cannot communicate and speak out of love, we're only going to be doing what? Going to battle. Marriage should not be a war zone, but we make it that with our words. Speak out of love. Build your marriage from a foundation of words spoken in love, with love, and of love. Love comes in all shapes and sizes. Be gentle with the words you construct, as you will either build up or you will tear down. How are you building up your relationship with your words? How are you tearing it down? We all play a role in this. And it really starts with you. You can't sit there and say, oh, but my, I get it. But who do you control? Only you. So where do you start today? Where can you start speaking out of love in your relationship? Maybe you have a few projects, that to-do list, that honey to-do list. And you're like, gosh darn it, I just wish. We've been trying to work on this for months now. Wouldn't it be nice if? I want you to really think about how can you address it without saying, you know, hun, we've been waiting a really long time for this. When are you ever going to get to it? That's not going to come across real good, because you know what? Maybe he's been stressed. Maybe she's been working way too much, volunteering at school, taking care of the kiddos. So coming together, unified, and figuring out the plan, everything what? Spoken out of love. It changes the conversation. How are you going to change your conversation today? If you want some help with this, click on the link, take aim in the show notes. I would be honored to come beside you and help you with this. It's not easy. In fact, remember our vocabulary that we continue to use over and over again? Well, that's the problem. We get stuck in a rut, and we use the same thing in our marriages when we talk to each other. And usually, the negative stuff that we talk to ourselves is the negative stuff that we talk to others. Be very careful. Click on the link, take aim in the show notes if you would like an opportunity to really chat about this. It's a coaching call with me. It's free, my gift to you. When you click on that link, that will begin our conversation. Remember, love comes in all shapes and sizes. Words have power. Use them wisely. Train for life and love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.